Margaret goes to school every day. One day, Carlos saw Margaret and he really liked her. It was the first time he fell in love. Every morning, Carlos stands on the road where Margaret goes to school and tries to say something. But Margaret doesn't look at him or think about anything. But Carlos is confident and thinks that one day he'll be successful. Carlos starts dreaming about Margaret from that day forward. Every day, Carlos wakes up, sees Margaret, and then goes to work. Carlos tries to give Margaret something, but she doesn't take it in the beginning. But Carlos stands in Margaret's way every day, so she starts taking Carlos's gifts. Carlos is thinking he'll be successful and starts dreaming about Margaret. Carlos is thinking he'll be successful and continues dreaming about Margaret. He starts giving Margaret more gifts and Margaret continues to take them. But Carlos didn't know that Margaret never took his gifts home. She took them and then threw them away. Margaret never thinks about anything. But Carlos is thinking about his future together with Margaret. Carlos never thinks that anything bad will happen to him. He never thinks negative. He keeps dreaming every day, every moment, and every second about Margaret. Carlos thinks that he won't have to stand in the streets any longer, that it'll end very soon. Carlos keeps trying to say something to Margaret every day, but Margaret never responds. He gives Margaret a letter every few days, but the girl never reads them. Whenever Carlos goes somewhere, he thinks that Margaret is with him. He never realizes that this isn't real, that it was only a dream. Suddenly, Margaret couldn't find Carlos anywhere when she went to school or came back. She thought about where he was. Maybe he was sick or got into an accident. Margaret didn't have any letter or gift from Carlos, but suddenly she remembered that she had one letter in her bag that she forgot to throw away. She she opened the letter to find a number or address, but there was no contact information. Instead, there was a message from Carlos to Margaret. Hi, I hope you're doing well. Maybe you're wondering why I write a letter to you every day. The first time I saw you, I immediately got attracted to you. I like everything about you. That's when I knew I want to know you more. Every day, I tried to approach you, but I think you find it weird for some strange guy to come up to you. So yes, I will let you know something about me. I came here to study. I have a brother and a sister. Both are in middle school. My mom passed away when I was 8, and now my dad is fighting pancreatic cancer. I wanted to tell you all of this in person, but unfortunately, we did not get the chance to know each other more. I've been staying here for a year just to see you every day, hoping that you would give us a try. This is my last letter to you. I finished my studies last year. Now, my visa's expired, and I have been overstaying in this country just to wait for your response. I applied many times to extend my visa and work permit, but I always got rejected. I have all the reason to go back home, but I chose to stay. Yesterday, a letter from court came saying that I have to leave this country within 7 days. And now I've decided I will follow the law. Court also gave a decision that I can't come back to this country anymore because I overstayed without any reason. Sorry to bother you every day on your way to school. I may not be perfect, but I wanted to give you all that I can. I hope you will find someone who will see you the way I did. I wish all the best for you. Thank you for always making my day. Take care of yourself. Margaret never fell in love with Carlos, but now she felt very guilty. She tried to forget everything, but she couldn't forgive herself.